Because there was no little this Ephesians at the very when Paul and Barnabas with them. It was decided that Paul, Barnabas, and some of the others should go out to Jerusalem to the apostles and elders about this question. The apostles and elders, in agreement with the whole church, decided to choose representatives and to send them to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas. The ones chosen were Judas, who was called Barsabas, and Silas, leaders among the brothers. This is a letter delivered by them. The apostles and the elders, your brothers, the brothers in Antioch, Syria and Sicilia, of Gentile origin, greetings. Since we have heard that some of our number who went out without any mandate from us have upset you with their teachings and disturbed your peace of mind, we have in one accord decided to choose representatives and to send them to you along with our beloved Barnabas and Paul, who have dedicated their lives to the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So we are sending Judas and Silas, who will also convey this same message by word of mouth. It is a decision of the Holy Spirit and of us not to place any burden beyond these cities, namely to abstain from being sacrificed to idols, from blood, from meat of strangled animals, and from unlawful marriage. If you keep free of these, you will be doing what is right. Farewell. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Listen to the song. O God, let all the nations praise you.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May God have pity on us and bless us. May you let His face shine upon us. So may your way be known upon earth, among all nations, your salvation.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May the nations be glad and exalt, because your word will be called in iniquity. The nations on the earth be valued.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May the people praise you, O God. May all the people praise you. May God bless us, and may all the ends of the earth fear you.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
I read in the book of Revelation. The angel took me in spirit to a great high mountain and showed me the holy city, Jerusalem, coming down from heaven from God. It glittered with the splendor of God. Its radiance was like that of gracious stone, that prospered, clear as crystal. It had massive high wall with 12 gates where 12 angels were stationed, and on which names were inscribed. The names of the 12 tribes of the Israelites. There were 3 gates facing east, 3 north, 3 south, and 3 west. The wall of the city had 12 courses of stones as its foundation, in which were inscribed the 12 names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. I saw a temple in the city, for its temple is the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb. The city had no need for sun or moon to shine on it, for the glory of God gave it light, and its Lamb was the Lamb. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
come to thee.
Early Christians, after Jesus died, resurrected, and ascended to heaven, He came up with a mission to spread good news so that every Christian community may start with the Jewish people, the Israelites. So at this moment, their group is very high. The group is very strong, unity, cohesion, and solidarity. But we are all the same. We eat same food, we have same customs. They are same, but we are same people, all Jewish people, Jewish Christians. But later on, the disciples, especially Paul and Barnabas, they tried also, because they feel the guidance of the Holy Spirit. They see the visions. And then they multiply the Gentiles also. Gentiles are not Jews. So there is an argument that comes. Because the Jewish Christians, they feel they are threatened, their heritage, the kosher food, the law of food, the circumcision. For them, it's very natural because they are Jewish people. But for the Gentiles, they say, this is not necessary for us to become a Christian. As long as we believe in Jesus Christ and to be baptized in his name, become a Christian. This is necessary. So there is the argument. And Paul and Barnabas, and the other side is Peter and James. So they have both sides. They do not agree. But they see the reality demand a change. That change also demands from them a duty of care, compassion, love, and inclusivity. Because not only Christians can be saved, but also the Gentiles. They see the necessary change. But for British Christian women, they are afraid to change. Because once they change, they are free, their Jewish heritage will get lost. Because they believe the law of food and circumcision is the heart of being in covenant with God. But Paul and Barnabas see differently. They will push them to a new understanding of being in covenant with God. It's not the law of food and circumcision, but the conviction and belief in Jesus Christ. So of course they debate, they have meeting together, and they pray together. They follow the guidance of the Holy Spirit, then they make the necessary change. Of course the change, the Gentiles does not need to be circumcised. And only observe a few the culture for the law. So this example tells us in our life we also need to make necessary change. Even though we do not like change, but the time comes, there's no choice for us. The condition forces us to change, and also the Holy Spirit guides us for a change. When I was in the United States, I was 2 years I was in the Second Park Church in Memphis, Tennessee. That church originally is for Asian population, but since young people are moving out and old people are passing away, so the Caucasian population increase. There's only like a meeting in the Sunday morning, 10 o'clock, they have an English class there. The group media about 40 people. But of course, there's a large number of Spanish speaking people came in. So this Caucasian small group, they feel their space and their church are invaded. They feel that way. And gradually, they see the reality. They start to accept. this new population of the church. Because too many of the Spanish speaking, they are about 200-300 if they come all together. There's a large number of people, Spanish speaking people. So what do they accept? A parish, the multicultural parish. Of course, part of us, we are Vietnamese, but we are about mostly 80-100 people. Three groups of people in the church. At the Caucasian group, at the very beginning, they are very, very exclusive. They don't want anybody else in the church. And later on, they want you to accept. After a while, because the Spanish speaking people, they see, you know, they are majority of the population in the parish. And whenever the parish needs help, they are, because they have many people, the parish also, they are very active in the parish. So they start to see if they have a 10 o'clock time slot for their mass, Spanish mass. So there is again another problem there, conflict. Even though the Caucasian group, they have few people, but they have long tradition, long history, and a lot in this mass. They have not changed yet. So this party went on for a while. Then they did not reach to a point, but people do understand. They listen to each other. They see that clearly, not the time to change the last time yet. So this is also one of the many examples we have. Of course, in St. Joseph, we are very multicultural also. You know, we have people from many countries, many cultures. Sometimes, you know, we have disagreement. Sometimes we have our small circles. Sometimes we also do not want anybody else. Very different from us, and keep ourselves. So this is because we are free. Most things forget to keep ourselves, and you know, we lose our balance. We cannot think we can install our mind. And think, you know, our mind and we will be big groups. So all these kind of thoughts, ideas, or views can be really sometimes to be obstacles to be a true and real followers of Jesus Christ. So that is the first reading that reminds us that, you know, we all are brothers and sisters in one community, in St. Joseph. We are all followers of Jesus Christ in a church. So sometimes even we see it as a necessary change. You know, we also need discuss about it, and also need to pray about it, and also together we pray and listen what the Holy Spirit has said to us, and follow what where the Holy Spirit will guide us to. So these are good examples for us. You know, we are challenged to make change. We are challenged to respond to the change, because, you know, once we make change, we are free, you know, that we are no longer our security and our safety kind of in risk, at the risk. But Jesus said to his disciples in gospel reading, do not let your heart be troubled. Jesus is going away. It's not the reason, not the cause for his disciples to be troubled. Anxious. Of course, for us, we see if there is necessary change. This reality is not a cause for us to be troubled or anxious or worried. And it is an opportunity for us to sit together, we pray together, we discern together, and at the end, we can follow the guidance of the Holy Spirit to make necessary change. So everyone. So as we continue to celebrate this Holy Eucharist, we pray for the grace that we can always be open-minded, open-hearted, so that once we see the lessons we achieve, we will pray about it, and hopefully we will also open our heart and receive guidance of the Holy Spirit, so that we can make the necessary change for a better condition, better environment for everyone, including in the church, and also this is what Jesus called us. Jesus said that the one flock, one shepherd, we are one. We are in unity, we are in solidarity. Of course, sometimes we feel we have a diversity, but we always pray for the unity in diversity. So now let us stand up and pray.
Thank you. faith fulfillment to the mysteries of the Almighty love. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifice of all to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commending himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of a sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with the paschal joy, every land, every people exalts your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unthinking will of glory and the acclaim.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, get to pray.
Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world.
Christ's announcement, our beloved Father Jesus Christ has completed his lifelong pilgrimage for Christ and entered our Father's house on the 14th May 2022 in Ireland. Father became a priest in residence at St. Joseph Church from 2020 and returned to Ireland in March 2022. In loving memory of St. Joseph Church, together with Colombian priest, is going to hold a memorial mass for Father Joe on Saturday, 28th of May, 2020 at 8 p.m. All are welcome to join us in prayers. The exhibition includes the St. Joseph rules. Go to St. Joseph images posted at the bulletin board. Take a picture and meet yourself like a selfie. Then write a reflection related to these images you choose. Submit in one size only and A4 piece of paper. Please find the application form at the entrance of the church. To submit, please put in a collection box at the parish office or send it to the exhibition WhatsApp number 9616-6867. You can send 5 or less than 5 entries with different images at St. Joseph with your picture and reflection in one in a piece of paper. Submission from May 1 until June 19. Please invite our members and friends to join in the exhibition. Write a reflection related to the images of St. Joseph. The prize is surprise. Thank you and God bless.
Let us pray. Almighty and living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increasing us, we pray, the fruit of this Paschal sacrament, the pour into our heart.